So in the previous class, we have discussed about the basics of OSI model, and we have studied about the working of OSI model we have discussed. So in today's class, we are going to study in detail about the all the different layers that we have, all the seven layers we have. So we'll be dealing with that. And as we know, from the application layer, the user can interact with the internet only at the application level. I mean, at this level, so he may be using his email services and other things. But when he wants to send some information, it will go to down the line with all the different layers like presentation, session, and so on. Then it will reach at the physical layer. So we'll be discussing about the functions of physical layer and data link layer in detail. So coming to this, and we already studied that at every layer, the header or the trailer information will be added, and that will be sent at the source side. And similarly, when that particular data reaches at the physical layer, then it will be converted into zeros and ones, and through the wire cables it will reach to the next station. And here we can say that the headers and trailers will be removed, and whatever the data is required, that will be sent to the upper layers. So this is what we have studied. So let's go ahead with the first thing, that is about the physical layer. So what basically physical layer will do? Can somebody tell me? Because already you have studied, so I want some interaction from your side. What do you know? What physical layer will do? At least from this diagram, you can understand.
It transporting the bits across the link.
Okay, good. So, but from where it will receive the data?
From a user.
From the layer.
From the user. Where it is getting the data? From which layer
from
it receives
data
the
data?
Yes. Data link layer.
So in data link layer, how the information will be there, in which form? Either it will be in terms of packets, or it will be in terms of frames.
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 Exactly. So if you consider this as the source side and this as the receiver side, so it gets the data from the data link layer, which will be in terms of frames. So it will break those all frames, and it will make them in terms of zeros and ones. Okay. And because why it has to make it is zeros and ones, because at the physical layer level, the communication will be in terms of wires. Okay. So whenever you are sending this data in terms of wires, that means you have to convert in terms of binaries. So because the two systems are connected physically here with the cable connections, so it will take that data and makes into zeros and ones, and that will be transferred into the source, I mean, at the destination side. Again, at the destination side, it will take all this bits pattern, and then it will send that to the data link layer. So this is at the brief level we have about the physical layer. So it coordinates the function required to carry bit stream over the physical media. So it is responsible for making these bit streams. So it deals with the mechanical and electrical specification. So how these zeros and ones are defined, and also the mechanical specifications. So it will include the following responsibilities. So let us study about these responsibilities. So it is responsible for transmitting individual bits from one to the next. So in this diagram, we are showing it as from A to B. So suppose say that we are communicating with A to B. So this A device is present at Belgaum, and this B device is present at somewhere, say, in Bengaluru. So in such cases, what exactly happens? So the device which is transmitting the data is not directly sending it to B. In between, there is something called as a subnet. So it will be transferring the data to the subnet, and through that subnet, and again, there can be n number of subnets. And through those subnets, the data will be reaching to the destination. So, but whenever we are studying, we take it as the source and the destination. But it is not exactly from the source to the destination, data transmission will not occur. So it will be from one system to the next system in that particular network, and so on it will reach to the destination. So it is responsible for transmitting individual bits from one to the next. So from A, it will send it to the nearest system, and from that nearest system to the next nearest system, and so on, it will reach to the destination. This is what we know about the subnet. And then about the physical characteristics of interface and media. So what are the physical characteristics? So it defines the characteristics of the interface between the devices and transmission media. So between the devices, what transmission media that we are using, or which type of cables we are using. So all these are the responsibility of the physical layer. Next, about the representation of bits. So suppose say that we have two systems and each is following a different coding system. So in the system A, it may be different. In system B, it may be different. So it will give a proper definition for what is the meaning of zeros and ones. So both the system who wants to communicate should also have the same representation of bits. So that will be taken care by the physical layer. What is the meaning of zero and what is the meaning of one? That will be defined by the physical layer. So, and these bits that it is sending and how it will be sent, whether it will be in terms of electrical signals or whether it in terms of optical signals. Like if you are using the fiber cable, then we need to use the optical signals. And if you are using the like LAN cable or coaxial cables and so on, then it will be in terms of electrical signals. So for that, it will take care of representation of these bits. So the physical layer defines the type of encoding. So how a zero is represented and how a one is represented, or how they are changed in terms of how they are represented in terms of signals. That is one important aspect. Next thing is about the data rate, or we can also call this as the transmission rate. So what is the data rate or transmission rate is all about? So the number of bits sent by the device each second, okay, the number of bits sent per second, we call it as the data rate, or we can call it as the transmission rate. This is also defined by the physical layer. So the physical layer basically defines the duration of a bit. So for how long this bit is available, so for how much time it will be existing in the network, so that will be identified by the data rate. So you just need to remember that data rate is nothing but the transmission rate. It means that how much bits of data you are transmitting per second, okay, or how much number of bits is transferred per second is called as the data rate. So that is the again task of the physical layer, or the function of the physical layer. Next, also about the synchronization of bits. We know that the sender and receiver are responsible for sending the bits or receiving the bits and so on, but there should be a proper synchronization between the two devices. Synchronization in the sense there should be a common understanding between the two devices. That means if the sender is sending the bits, like for example, it can send say suppose 50 100 bits per second, so the receiver should be able to occupy those, or it should be able to receive those 100 bits in same 1 second. So that is what is the understanding should happen between the sender and the receiver. That is about the synchronization. So the sender and receiver not only must use the same bit rate, but they should also must be synchronized. They should also have the proper understanding when they want to send or receive the bits. Next, about the line configuration. So the line configuration can be again in two types. Like we have studied about the configuration, that it can be a point-to-point configuration or it can be a multi-point configuration. So which type of configuration it is going to use, that will be again defined by the physical layer. In case if it is just within the network, it can use the point to point. If it is want to have a multipoint, it can have the multipoint configuration. So that will be identified, or that will be the defined by the physical layer. Next, we have about the physical topology. As we all know, that is the representation or geometric representation of the devices or the network and how these devices are connected. So for that, we require this physical topology. So this physical layer is responsible for which type of topology it is going to use, or which type of topology is best suited for a particular type of network. So that will be taken care by the physical topology. So the topology can be a mesh topology, star topology, ring topology, and so on. That will be defined by the physical physical layer. Next is about the transmission mode. As we know that the physical layer also defines the direction of transmission. So we have studied three types of transmission modes. What are those? Can somebody tell me? Three modes of data flow we have discussed. What are those? Transmission modes. Which are the three modes in which data can flow?
Half duplex, full duplex, and simplex.
Duplex, full duplex.
Exactly. Yes. So the physical layer is responsible for defining these modes of transmission or the direction of transmission. So these are the responsibilities or the functionalities of the physical layer. Anybody has any doubts? So you'll be writing these important points. So here just the points have been given. So you will be explaining in brief about these things. Is that clear for everyone? Shall we go ahead?
Yes, sir.
So in one sentence, what you can remember is the physical layer is responsible for movements of individual bits from one hop to the next. So here there is a term called as hop. Hop is nothing but a node. That means it is responsible for transmission of the bits from one system to the next system. It doesn't mean that next can be the destination machine or next can be some other machine as well. Suppose say that the computer is present at side by side, if I'm communicating, then the destination machine as the next machine will be same. But if I'm communicating with from one system and the other system is located somewhere else, then that there is no direct communication is occurring. So it will send it to the next nearest system, and so on, it will reach to the destination. So that is what is the meaning of transmission from one hop to the next hop, or from one node to the next node. Let's go ahead with the data link layer. So what are the responsibilities of data link layer? Can somebody can remember, if you remember this? What is the responsibility of it?
It's for the frames.
Flow control.
Okay, flow control is also good. This frames is also correct. Then what else?
Sir, it has two sublayers, logical link control sublayer and MAC sublayer, that is media.
Okay. Any other things?
Sir, it detects errors.
Okay. Error detection, flow control. Okay. So as you already know these things, so basically it receives the data from the network layer, and what it will do? It will make packets or it will make frames?
Packets. Frames.
Somebody is telling packets, somebody is telling frames. What is the correct one?
Frames.
So from the network layer, whatever data it is accepting, it will be in terms of basically in packets. So it will take those packets one by one, and then it will break into smaller frames. And then it will add its headers and trailers. Again, as I said, headers and trailers are not compulsory. I mean, trailers are not compulsory. It depends on the network architecture, but it will add its headers, and then that will be sent to the physical layer, and then it is also responsible for flow control and so on. So let us discuss in this detail now. And again, when it goes to the other device from the physical layer, it receives the bits and then it will convert them into frames, and then it will forward those frames into the network layer. So let us understand this now in detail. So the first responsibility, is moving frames from one hop to the next. So it will make the frames that whatever the bits it has got, it will make them into frames, and it is responsible for transferring or moving these frames from one system to the next system or from one node to the another. So what is the meaning of this framing? This you need to highlight when you are writing in the exam. So it divides the stream of bits received from the network layer into manageable data units called as the frames. Consider that it depends on the operating system again. So it can take 8 bits or it can take 16 bits and it can make them into one particular frame. So like that, it will make these different frames, and these frames will be transferred to the next layer, that is to the physical layer. So divides the stream of bits received from the network layer into manageable data units called as the frame. The next thing is about the physical addressing. So this is we need to discuss. So what is a physical address and what is a logical address in terms of networking? Okay, don't confuse these two things related to the operating system. In that also we had something called as physical address and logical address. I will keep that aside. We will discuss on what is a physical address and what is a logical address in terms of networking. Can somebody give me an example? Or we can also call it as the MAC address. Anybody knows this? Or anybody at least know how to know the, or where I can get the IP address of my system? Like if I want to know my IP address, okay, how I can know that? Do you know what is the IP address at least?
Yes, sir.
Okay, Abhishek Mutt has said IP config, correct. So what is an IP address?
Internet protocol.
Yeah, but what is that? How it will be? Can somebody give me an example for an IP address? Suppose say that. Okay, 192.168.0.2. Exactly. So I will take this only from Abhishek. So he has given an IP address. So this is what we call it as the IP address. Okay. So this IP address is unique for every system which is connected to the internet. So in the internet world, there are billions of computers. When you are communicating through the internet or you are searching something on the Google, you should have something called as the IP address, which will be unique for every system when you are connected to the internet. And apart from that, we have something called as a MAC address, or we call it as the physical address, which is meant for every individual system. And this we will get by the manufacturers. But whereas these IP addresses, or we can also call it as the logical address, can be changed according to our wish, or we can change, or we can have a control over it for the IP addresses. But for the physical address or the MAC address, is again, this is also unique, but it is based on the network interface card, or it we can get it by the manufacturers or of our systems. So to know the MAC address, just open the command prompt. Here you have to type something called as IP config. This is the command space slash all. So if you type this, you will get all the details about your network system. That is, what is your logical address? I mean, what is your IP address, IPv4, IPv6, your physical address, whether you are having the Ethernet cable, I mean, Ethernet connection, your Wi-Fi connections, your Bluetooth, all those details will get. So just when you type this, here we'll get all the details. So here you can see the Windows IP configuration. Here you can see the physical addresses. So if you are attached to the Ethernet cable, this is the physical address. Similarly, for wireless LAN and other details, this is the physical address, and so on and so forth. So similarly, we have something called as the logical address. So here we can have logical address of two type. One is IPv4 and IPv6. IPv4 is the one that currently we are using. IPv6 will be the future. So we are not going to use that now. I mean, currently we are not using that. We are using the only IPv4 addresses. So this is my current IPv4 address that my system is connected to. So I have connected to a Wi-Fi connection, and this is my IPv4 address. So this logical address will be unique for every system which is connected to the internet, and we can have the physical address, or we can call it as the MAC address. So you can see this physical address. Are we getting it, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Now the things comes is how it transfers the data. So for that, we call it as the hop-to-hop delivery, okay, of these frames. So the data link layer is responsible for moving frames from one hop to the next hop. Okay, so let us take this example and try to understand it. Suppose say that the system A wants to send data to B. Okay, then this system will send it to the next link. Okay, so basically it will go to the data link layer and physical layer of that system, and then it will go to the next. So what is there here? We have something called as B. So B is not a device here. B is nothing but a router. So what this router will do? Router will identify what is the path that is available. Now basically the task of the router is to find a route, or to find the best route or the shortest route. So we have got some algorithms based on that. So it will select a particular route. From there, it will send the data to the next node. So when we talk about sending the data from, say, let us say from A to F, so we'll take the example. So if A wants to send these frames, okay, let us say that this is the frame A wants to send, and when it is sending, it will have add something called as headers and trailers. Okay, so what is the header? It will be the source address. Okay, and what is the trailer? Trailer is the next hop. I'm taking a simple example. This is the frame what A wants to send to F, but what is the next device? The next device that is present is B. So it will add the trailer as B. So this frame will arrive to B. This frame has arrived to B. Now B wants to send the data through this link, and it wants to send to E. So again, what will happen? B receives this particular frame, and what it will do? It will change this physical address. It will change it to, from A, it will make it to B, because B is the source from where the frame will be sent. And what is the destination? Destination is E. So every time the data is being transferred, this physical address is going to change, because this data link layer is responsible for hop to hop delivery. It is not, it will not understand, or it is not responsible for whether this frame is being sent to F. That is not the actual responsibility of the data link layer. It just wants to send the frames from the current system, or from A to the next system. So what is the next system? Next system is B. And from B, what is the next system? it is E. But actually the data has to be transferred from A to F, but it is responsible for only sending the frame from one hop to the next hop. And from B, it will reach the E. Again, when it comes to E, what can be the source and what can be the destination? What I should put in this? What will happen to this? Can somebody tell me? This is the frame. When this frame arrives to E, what will be the changes at this particular frame?
EF.
Exactly. So it means that the source is E and the destination is F. So here instead of this, we can take FR, which means that it is a frame. Are we getting it, everyone? So every time the when a frame is transferred, the physical address is going to be affected. So this is what we mean by hop to hop. So it will come from A, it will go to the data link layer and physical layer. Then again, it will go to the physical layer of this device, that is B. And from there, it will go to the data link layer. And then it will choose the path, whether it to send to this C or to E. So it will choose E. The moment it chooses E, these two will be affected. And from E, it will again go to the data link layer and physical layer. From there, it will be sent to the next device, that is F. So every time the physical address or the MAC address will be changed, because A is sending to B, B is sending to E, and so on. So this is a data link layer is responsible for only hop to hop delivery. Understood, everyone? So when we discuss about network layer, that time we'll understand. But when we say about the network layer, there will be a source machine, okay, and the source machine will have the IP address, and also it wants to send to the destination machine, that is the that can be present anywhere. So it will have the source device and the destination device, and it will have the IP addresses. Those IP addresses cannot be changed, but here it will be just changing this physical address, because it is from one hop to the next hop. So this is the important task of the data link layer. Next, as we know about the physical address. So if frames are to be distributed to different systems on the network, the data link layer adds a header. So if it wants to send to the send these frames outside the boundary, suppose say that if there are 10 computer systems are connected, if it wants to send to the data to a system which is not present or which is not within that particular network, then it will add these headers and then it will be transferred. So if the frame is intended for the system outside the sender's network, the receiver address is the address of the device that connect to the network to the next one. So this is what basically happens. And next thing about we discuss, you know about, is the flow control. So what is the flow control? If the rate at which protocols are there, fine. But basically flow control is all about how much synchronized, or how the source machine and the destination machine are synchronized. So for example, say that if the receiver's capacity is, it can accept five frames per second, then the sender should also send only 5 frames per second. So there should be a coordination between the sender and the receiver. So that is about the flow control. If the rate at which the data are absorbed by the receiver is less than the rate at which data are sent by the or produced by the sender, then again there will be no balance between the sender and the receiver. So there should be a flow control. So this will be managed by the data link layer. And also, if there are any damages that may occur or during the transmission, if the frames are lost, then it is responsible for retransmission of these frames. And also there can be possibility of duplicate frames. Suppose say that the sender has send some frames. Suppose that it has sent 5 frames, 4 frames have arrived at right time, but the 5th frame is not arrived. So what the receiver will think? Receiver will think that the 4th frame is, I mean, the 5th frame is not yet arrived. So it will say that please retransmit this. So the earlier frame will also come, the original frame, the frame which has been retransmitted, both the frames will come. So again, there can be possibility of duplicates. So to avoid these duplicate frames, the data link layer will use this encoding scheme or the error control mechanism. So it also is responsible for finding these duplicate frames, and it will use these error control mechanisms. Like it can use trailers at the end of the frame. By using these headers and trailers, it can manage those things. And also it uses some techniques. Error detection mechanisms also can be used in case of the data link layer. And then the next one is the access control. Next, for example, when two devices are connected to the same link, okay, if the two devices are connected to the same link at the same time, then the data link layer will define who will have the control over it. So if A and B are connected to the same link, then data link layer will define whether A is going to use at now or B is going to use, or when A and B can use together, or whether they should use one after the other and so on. That will be defined by the or determined by the data link layer. So these are the basic responsibility of the data link layer. Basically, first one is moving frames from one hop to the other hop, and the one important thing is the framing. So dividing these bits of frames into smaller units or manageable data units called as the frames, and then comes the physical address. From one system to another system, how the data is being sent or how the frames have been sent, and when it is sending these frames, it will change the physical address. So if it is the destination machine is within the network, then or the system which was going to send, if it is next to the current system, then that will be nothing but the physical address. But if it is system is present somewhere outside the network, it will send it to the intermediate nodes, and every time when it is sending to the intermediate nodes, the address is going to be changed. And then about the flow control, the sender and receiver should have the proper understanding between the data transmission of the frames, and then the error control to avoid the duplicate frames, or if the frames are lost due to traffic or due to congestions, there can be possibility of error that can occur. So these error can be detected by the data link layer, and then the access control and the hop to hop delivery. So these are the responsibility of the data link layer. So the data link layer is responsible for moving frames from one hop to the next. Next, we will discuss about the network layer. So the network layer is responsible for what? So the delivery of individual packets from the original source to the final destination. And here we have something called as logical addressing, routing, and then source to destination delivery. So here it is responsible for end to end. But whereas in case of data link layer, it is from hop to hop. But whereas in network layer, it is from end to end. So if the in case of data link layer, if A has transmitted to B, then the data link layer which is working at A, task is done. When B wants to send the data to E, the data link layer which is working at B is responsible for only checking or only confirming whether the data from B has reached to E or no. It is not worried about whether from E to F it is transmitted or no. That will not be responsible for the data link layer which is working at B, and so on. But whereas in case of network layer, it is from source to destination delivery. So if the data is not transmitted from source to the original destination machine, then there can be a problem, or the layer which is working at the source machine, that will be the responsible. So So the network layer basically takes the data from the transport layer and makes them into something called as the packets, and these packets will be sent to the data link layer. So basically these are the applications of, these are the responsibilities or the functionalities of the network layer. So what are packets basically? What do you mean by packets? Yes, I'm asking you.
Group of data.
Group of data.
Yes.
So like we had frames, similarly we can make these frames, and by these frames can be combined and we can make them into smaller individual units of data, we can say. Those are nothing but these small packets, individual small units of data, we can call it as the packet. So it is responsible for making these packets and then sending these packets to the from source to the destination machine. Basically these packets will be sent to the next layer, that is the data link layer, and so on. And then here we are going to study about the logical address. If the packet passes the network boundary, we need another addressing system to help to the connection. That here we require the logical addressing. So in the next class, we will discuss about these in detail and also the routing purpose. So it is also responsible for routing. That is the, we come across the router. So in the next class, we are going to study about something called as hubs, switches, and routers first. And then we are going to study in detail about these things.